It started out as a fun game, but ended up with her life on the line. Hey guys, welcome back to Flix Recap. My name is Luke Pelletier, and today we're covering the 2016 thriller, Nerve. Be sure to like the video, drop a comment, and of course subscribe to Flix Recap if you dig the commentary. And as a quick reminder, this video contains spoilers, so you have been warned. The movie starts with our main lead, Venus, chatting with her best friend, Sydney. Sydney tells Venus to join Nerve, a new game where people complete dares, and then the two most popular players end up in a box where they compete for first place. Venus finds it sketchy, but upon Sydney's insistence, promises to sign up later. At her high school, Venus is covering the football match for her school newspaper. Venus has a particular interest in JP Guerrero, who's the captain of the team. Meanwhile, Sydney with the cheerleading squad. As per her dare on Nerve, Sydney flashes her bum in front of the entire school. A little weird, but not that unexpected for a dare. Sydney is suspended, but she still wants Venus to join Nerve. Venus is simply too shy to take the risks of doing weird dares. To prove a point, Sydney decides to do a dare for her and goes ask JP out for Venus. Things don't turn out very well, as poor Venus is just not his type, and he rejects her. Embarrassed and angry, Venus rushes back home and instantly joins Nerve to see if it'll make her more confident. It's nighttime and Venus gets her first dare. She has to kiss a stranger for 5 seconds at Colonnade Diner. So she drives there with her friend Tommy. At the diner, Venus comes across Ian. She hands the phone to Tommy to record, goes up to the guy and kisses him. Once the dare's completed, Venus rushes back to her booth, but it's not over yet. The next minute, Ian is singing aloud as he dances his way to Venus. It is then that they get their next dare. The Watchers want the two of them to go around the city together. Tommy tries to stop Venus, but she's feeling a bit rebellious. So Venus joins Ian on his bike, and the two of them ride into the city at night. Venus and Ian stop outside a mall for Ian's next dare. They say their goodbyes and then part ways. However, Venus suddenly gets a dare to try on a dress at the same mall. Venus hunts down the dress and finally finds it at the couture floor, aka the very expensive floor. She completes the dare, and while she's checking herself out, Ian joins her all dressed up in a fancy suit. Ian's dare is to complete Venus's ensemble, so the two choose different shoes to go with Venus's dress. It's all very sweet, but things get a little more interesting with the next dare. For their next dare, Ian and Venus have to leave the store. The twist is that their own stuff is gone. Ian suggests leaving with the fancy clothes on, but Venus is not one for shoplifting, so the two of them strip down and make a run for their dignity. Once they get outside, Ian and Venus find the same expensive clothes they just left in the store, and it's all paid. Their next dare pops up. This time, Venus has to get a tattoo of Ian's choice. At the tattoo store, Ian decides to draw something for her. It's a lighthouse. Meanwhile, Sydney is getting concerned over Venus's growing popularity, so she calls Tommy. Tommy tries uncovering Ian's profile because he's got some hacking skills, but the guy is a ghost on the internet. After exploring the dark web, Tommy finds out that Ian was completing dares with the person who died doing a dare for Nerve the previous year. He rushes to rescue Venus. For their next dare, Venus and Ian have to ride to the park and 25th. The tricky bit is that Ian has to do it blindfolded and at 60 miles an hour. Venus is hesitant and almost bails out, but Ian is good at convincing her and makes her do the dare with him. While all the Watchers clutch their hearts as the two of them ride across the busy streets of New York City, the duo complete their dare with success. To celebrate their victory, Venus impulsively kisses Ian. Ian looks slightly taken aback, but then returns the kiss. Meanwhile, Sydney is freaking out over Venus's success. She gets asked by another Nerve player named Ty to team up with her, so they can end up in the box and win the finals. Sydney turns him down, but Ty still gives his number to her. After some exhilarating adventures and completing the dares, Venus and Ian decide to get pizza and then go on a carousel. Right then, Sydney, who's been a-watching Venus's dares at a party, calls her. Venus hits decline on the call and opens up about her friendship with Sydney to Ian. Venus tells Ian how she does not want to be Sydney's sidekick anymore and that it's Sydney who is a real sad sight with all her drinking and other problems. Sydney on the phone hears it all, word for word, and so impulsively decides to take on new drivers. Her new dare is to get super drunk and walk across a ladder connecting two apartment buildings, all the while recording herself. She's very angry at Venus for stealing her spotlight, so she decides to go all out. Meanwhile, Ian suggests going to the party where Sydney is. Too drunk to carry on, Sydney fails to complete her dare. One of the two people who get to the finals box round is Ty, who somehow manages to lie under a running train and still not get a single scratch. Venus and Ian make it to the party. The two of them are welcomed like celebrities. Everyone is cheering for them. The first thing Venus does is try to find Sydney. She goes to various rooms and ends up finding Sydney hooking up with JP. Venus does not want to talk to Sydney, so she takes Ian's hand and starts to walk out of the party. However, Sydney is not going to let Venus go so easily. Okay guys, quick pause to remind you to comment, like the video, and subscribe to the channel if you like what you see. On with the recap. Sydney calls out Venus for being such a cowardly, boring person her whole life and tells her to wake up from the stupid dream she's living while playing the game. Enraged, Venus does not let Sydney have the final say. While Venus unburdens herself of everything she's ever wanted to say to Sydney, she gets her new dare. Venus's new dare is to complete Sydney's dare. Without thinking twice, Venus makes her way to the window, climbs on the ladder, and completes the dare in no time. Venus not only makes a point that she's as cool and fun as Sydney, she also wins the other first place in the box round. In the other building, while making her way out, Venus crashes into Tommy. Tommy tells Venus that Ian has played the game before and his partner passed away. The truth is revealed, and it turns out Ian's dare was to get Venus to the party and get her to fight with Sydney. Venus is too stunned to say anything. Ian tries to explain his doings to her, but Venus is not having any of it. Venus rushes out of the apartment and runs straight to a police officer to make a complaint about the game. Other nerve watchers chant snitch as Venus tries explaining the situation to the officer, but the police officer can't do much about it since there's no actual crime being committed. Venus then gets a call from her mother, who tells Venus that all of their money is missing from their bank accounts. While on the call with her mom, she gets stopped by Ty, who punches Venus in the face. Venus wakes up in a wooden box. There's a small TV screen that addresses her and tells her that since she snitched on the game, Venus is now a prisoner to Nerve. The game controls her life. The only way out for her is to win the final round. Venus is told to go to the Staten Island Ferry, where the Watchers will find her. Furious but with no way out, she says yes. Venus kicks open the box to get out. Just in time, Ian finds her. She demands the truth and Ian finally speaks up. It so happens that Ian and Ty, along with another kid named Robbie, had played Nerve the previous year in Seattle. They were dared to hang from a construction crane that was 200 feet in the air. Unfortunately, Robbie fell. Ian and Ty bailed and went to the police, but the police simply called it an accident. What followed was much worse. Ian's dad lost his job, his sister's photos got leaked, and their identities were stolen. Ian and Ty became prisoners of the game, and their only way out as prisoners was to win. Ian says he's got a plan to get Venus to win. He's asked the Watchers to give him a dare to win Ty's spot at finals, so it'll be Ian and Venus in the final. That way Venus can beat Ian and be free. Ian drops Venus at an abandoned parking lot where Tommy and Sydney join her and then rides away to Fifth Avenue for his dare. While Venus and her friends try to change the code of the game to gain some access, Ian has to climb up the cranes and hang in the air for 5 seconds. The dare is a piece of cake for Ian, and he completes it with ease. Venus makes her way to the ferry while Tommy and Sydney try to bring the game down. For her dare, Venus has to get away with a gun in front of a police officer, and she succeeds. Venus then goes to an arena for the final round where she meets Ian. Both Venus and Ian have guns, and their dare is to shoot the opponent. With only 20 seconds on the clock, Venus shoots at the ground and simply refuses to play. Right then, Ty offers to play in her place, but Venus is quick to offer herself as a sacrifice. She'd rather do that than risk losing Ian to Ty. The crowd votes yes to shoot Venus, and so Ty does. Or so it looks like. Venus only pretends to get shot so that Tommy could use it as a distraction to destroy the game. Every single Watcher gets a message to sign out or become an accessory to murder. Slowly, everyone signs out. Ty was in on the plan as well since Sydney had called him. When Ty signs out as the last player, the game crashes down. The movie comes to an end with Ian revealing his real name is Sam. Venus and Sam meet again, but this time for all the right reasons. Would you participate in this kind of game? Share your thoughts in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Until next time.